drugs and the alcohol lifestyle were the most important, and Lowell was more focused on being the best band possible. According to the Woodland Rivalry, which was a recorded interview and actually released as a single eventually. Despite all this bad behavior, or rather with the help of it, they were rapidly on the rise to fame. It's hard to follow up a debut album of that success, but with the songwriting of Noel and the vocal talent of Liam, they showed out on the 95 album, What's the Story, Morning Glory. This album was song after song of anthems, including Don't Look Back in Anger, Morning Glory, Champagne Supernova, and of course, Wonderwall. This album once again reached number one spot in the UK and even reached the top 10 in America. And it's one of the best-selling albums of all time. This album alone sold almost 30 million. And it's spawned massive world tours, sold out all across the world, or in many different countries now. After 2 years of touring and releasing albums, they were ready to return to Manchester for their major homecoming gig. They were all Manchester City fans their whole life and always dreamed of playing there and selling it out. And in April of 1996, they sold out two nights in Main Road Stadium, 40,000 each night. And looking back on it in the documentary, they all stated that this night was truly a special homecoming event for the band, and it was one of the most special gigs that they ever played. In August of 1996, the band was at an all-time high in their fame, preparing for the largest concert in British history. Netherwood Park in Hertfordshire, England, holds a capacity of 150,000 people, and they were anxious about being able to sell it out. Nervous, too, but looking back at it, 4% of England's entire population applied for tickets, with almost 3 million tickets being applied for. They could have sold out the venue for 18 nights in a row, but obviously they just played two. 18 nights would be absurd. And this was both nights were broadcasted live all across the country and many other European countries. And all this about this concert is from the British Broadcasting Company, BBC. And at this moment in time, they were really the biggest band around in the planet. They never really got that big in the United States, but everywhere else they were just massive. And according to the documentary and also the live video that I've seen at this concert, Noel walks out on the stage and just yells, "This is history," and it really was at that moment in time. Their next album, Be Here Now, spawned a massive world tour, but their next few albums did not have quite the same effect, although they were majorly successful. Things started to heat up in the band. They went on for a few more years, but things got worse between Liam and Noel. They always had issues. New faces swapped in and out of the lineup for the next few years, but Liam and Noel were the constant. Those two together are kind of Oasis. But in 2009, the band split. Liam and Noel couldn't bear it any longer. They haven't spoken since. According to Rolling Stone magazine, Noel threw something at Liam in the dressing room, and Liam retaliated by breaking Noel's favorite guitar right before they were set to go on, and that was just the end of the band. In 2017, after 4 years off of music, Liam made his comeback, releasing As You Were, which reached the number one in the UK and top 20 in the US, and the Rock and Roll Star is back. He's been on tour for the last year and a half for this album, and I've seen him a few times on this tour. His brother Noel has been in Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds for the last 9 years, and I just got to see them recently in February. To conclude, there are a few things we can take from this speech. First off is how they came from nothing to being one of the most successful bands. This just shows that if you keep your mind to something, you can accomplish it. Like Liam says, he knew they were going to be the best band on the planet, and that's what drove them to have success.